Hi guys, welcome back to another video from my channel. So today is gonna be my 16th necro attempt. 16th. And it's gonna be my 16th attempt and hopefully I'll get my necro today. But to start off the video today, I actually wanna do an enhancement on just one of my items. Maybe my Fafnir top, yeah. So I have some scrolls here, so I wanna enhance my Fafnir top to see if when it gets emblem, then it will become usable straight away. So let's go and failed. Yay, 13 stars. Okay, I actually also have some legendary pot scroll that I want to use. So I actually have decided as well that I do not want to L pot my weapon because the potential is already very good at unique. It's a 10.1% crit damage, which is also quite hard to even get at L legendary pot. So I'm not gonna L pot this, but instead I'm gonna L pot my cape, because actually cape also gives physical damage increase, so that is pretty good for improvement from the current. Okay, so I got a 3% scroll. Let's see if we can pass this on my cape. Nope, I still have no legend pot scroll now, you know. How sad is that? Oh goodness. Okay, I also told you guys that I wanted to show you guys Nightwalker, how is Nightwalker after the buff. So I'm just gonna do a guild dungeon now without any class buffs, just my own Nightwalker buffs, and then we'll see how we fare against our previous guild dungeon attempt before the patch. So let's go try it out now. Okay, so what's different about this attempt, right, is that I'm gonna do my hyper first, because the hyper is not needed now. My hyper now gives 2 minutes worth of buff each time I use it. So during the run for the GD, I won't use it at all because I don't need the buff from it. It already lasts 2 minutes throughout. Because the damage from the hyper is actually lesser than that if I just do a normal attack. That's why I'm not gonna use it. So I think I did 7 point something million in the pre-patch guild dungeon, and now I'm already surpassing 8 million, going to 9 million. Am I even be able to hit 10? Will I be able to hit 10? Oh my god, 10.2 million unbuffed. That's almost a 50% increase from my 7 million previously. Wow, that is the amount of buffs that Nightwalker got. Holy shit. Okay, that is great. So now let's move on to the main event of today's video, the necro attempt 16. So right now my weapon is again at 3 out of 3 mastercraft failure count. I got no mythics that I wanna use here, so I actually have to go and go to my Hotel Maple Aim and buy a mythic weapon box. So I'm gonna use this mythic weapon box as my mythic reduction to use for reduction. I'm already out of mesos here, can't really, don't really want to spend that money buying a mythic weapon. So I'm just gonna use this. This is the one with the E. So take note guys, you can actually use the weapon with the E to make this Mastercraft failure count reduction screw. Alright. So let's use the scroll. Right. Okay guys, 16th attempt. Will I get it this time? Come on Nexon, you gotta give this to me man. 16th attempt. I think I've bought around 13 mythics already, and that is more than 6B worth of mesos, and the amount of crystals I spent buying the Chaos Daily dungeon tickets. Come on, 16th attempt, 4%. Let's go! No, I failed. Nexon. Nexon, why you do this? Why you do this? Nexon, why you do this? When will I get my Necro Nexon? Oh my goodness. Anyway. There's this new MapleMon event that actually gives pretty good items, so you guys should definitely play it. Level up your MapleMons. So my MapleMons are actually all already level 100. So they're already level 100. Just trying to get the daily reward, the happiness reward, by making them sleep for 120 minutes. So the reward, if anyone of you are curious and hasn't reached level 100 yet, right? So at level 100, you'll get this achievement for each MapleMon that you hit level 100. So the first MapleMon will give you this. This is a stage 4 growth box, and inside it will be one of each scroll: Shielding Ward, Shield Scroll, and Lucky Day Scroll. Pretty good. And the next MapleMon at level 100 will give you 2 1-hour AB, Prototype Soul Enchanter, and a Brilliant Mysterious Soul Shard Box. So if you want to see what's inside here, it actually gives you all the RA Soul Shards, like, randomly, by chance. But you have a chance to get any of the RA Soul Shards, which is pretty good. And lastly, this box gives you 3 Black Cubes, 10 Red Cubes, and 1 Choice Cube. It gives you everything. All items will be acquired. So this is the best box, I feel, out of all. And yeah, I think definitely the MapleMon event is good, and you guys should go and level up your MapleMons. And also there will be a MapleMon coin shop that will open, and it has emblem scrolls, I think. So do keep a lookout for that. It's opening in 3 days time. So yeah, I think that's all I have for you guys in today's video. Sorry for the mic problem in the previous video. I hope it is fixed in this video. Yeah, if it's not fixed, probably this video will be up. But yeah, I think there was some issue with my mic previously, but I think it's already fixed. So we'll see. And I think that's all for today's video. Thank you guys for watching yet again, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye!